The debt today is so high, it's 200,000 rupees, 300,000 rupees of peasant who have no capital. They, who know within a year or two, when they accumulate that kind of debt, they will never be able to pay back. Where is the debt coming from? It's coming from a seed that is costing 100,000 to 200,000 rupees per kilogram, depending on what you got. Seed that used to be free, used to be theirs. Pesticides each time. The more they use, the more they have to use. 12 sprays, 15 sprays, 20 sprays. Pesticides used in just the last 5 years in the land areas of India has shot up by 2,000%. That's what the free market and globalization have brought. And since we are talking about peasants, who have no money, who have no capital, they can only buy expensive seeds and expensive pesticides by borrowing. And who lend them that money? The same companies that sell the pesticides, which are the same companies that sell the seeds, as you know, are now also the major creditors.
There are a number of possible purposes for a social network. You now have a good understanding of how to analyze the basic characteristics of your social network or that of another individual. Network is a social relationship which helps transfer information, such as traveling from one place to another. It also helps people get to different destinations more quickly if they need to travel in a long distance or two destinations. It is suitable for old cities with high density population like Paris. There are thousands of trips and too many travelers every day in Paris. The transportation network in Paris provides thousands of public services and links them together. A good network can help people with long distance or multi-destination trips. In cities with high density population such as Paris, people would better carefully plan their journeys by looking at the routes of the network in advance, to reduce the density of commuters at the same time.
The first Australians, the Aboriginal people, have been in Australia for over 40,000 years. The first European settlers who arrived over 200 years ago were mainly English. And over the last 100 years, Australia has become home to a number of immigrants from all over the world. Australians are now a very diverse group of people who have cultural and family links with hundreds of countries all over the world. They have a wide variety of skin color, accents, ways of dressing, family life, and lifestyles. Many international visitors also come to Brisbane and the Gold Coast to study, all for holidays every year, which further increases the variety of people within the region. This has led to a great diversity in events, resources, food, and facilities, providing for a number of people from many cultural backgrounds.
your journey.